Yvonne, thanks for your time. You must be incredibly proud of Sam Stosur, considering that you were the last Australian woman to win a Grand Slam title at Wimbledon in 1980.
Oh, very proud. I know how she feels, because I was exceptionally proud because I did win Wimbledon in 71 when I was 19, and then won Wimbledon again. It was my last Grand Slam after having my daughter Kelly in 80. So that made me extra proud, I think, as being a mother.
Do you think the fact that she could stand and slug it out with Serena Williams was one of the key factors in her victory?
The big plus for her is a serve. She's got absolutely amazing. It's the best serve in women's tennis today. But it seems like all her ground strokes were coming off, and she had the power, and that was because she was moving so much better on the court. And she's much fitter than I've ever seen her.
And you must be very proud of Ashley Barty, who's made the semi-finals of the girls' junior title.
Yeah, oh, definitely. I'm very proud of her for doing well at Wimbledon, really, winning the juniors. I was kind of, you know, texting her every day and calling her every day just to inspire her to sort of keep going and, you know, play well. And, I think after winning the junior event there, she can only improve also. She did well to get to the, the semi-final of the US Open. But I texted her and she said, that hurt. But, you know, she knows what she's capable of doing. And I know that, she is capable of winning more tournaments.
And are you satisfied with the level of development assistance that some of the younger female players are getting?
Well, I don't know, because I really don't work for Tennis Australia. For the last 7 years, I've been working with, in fact, when I leave here, we'll have to start working on our national camp for the first week of the Australian Open. Our camps are not just about becoming better tennis players, but also creating jobs. We have seven coaches now, Indigenous coaches and sports and rec officers. We give out tennis scholarships to different schools. In fact, there was two of them this year went to university. And so that's the real plus. So this is pretty well what this program here today is about, the Learn, Earn, Legend program's about. It's about what we've been doing for the last 7 years, but it's a continuation of that. And I hope to do come and try days in every state for Indigenous kids. I want to see more Indigenous kids playing tennis. And the legends of our camps are going to be the ones who are going to get out there and inspire those young kids to play tennis. So it's not just about putting them on the tennis courts, it's about going, speaking to the elders, speaking to the parents, and providing rackets and equipment for them, and which is why I've started up the Yvonne Goolagong Foundation. And I want to try and help those kids, because I think it stems from growing up in Burrell in my hometown in New South Wales. It was the townspeople that first helped me. I couldn't afford to, get the clothes and go to tournaments and so on. They helped me. So I feel like I can do the same for other young kids around Australia. And there's a lot of talent out there. I mean, you find that a lot of the young Indigenous kids have great hand-eye coordination. We're going to work on that. But as I said, it's not just about becoming better tennis players, but also coaches, administrators, getting a job, and making life better for them, really.